Nope, this isn't clickbait. Yes, I really got rear-ended.
Honestly, it was an eye-opening experience. I've been using the same practice for years and it finally paid off. In this video, we're gonna dive down into my accident and I'll explain why motorcyclists need to use this practice every time they ride. Now let's hop into it. Now let me explain what happened. Before I left work, I was out in the parking lot practicing some slow speed maneuvers and my kickstand spring fell off. I ended up having to jerry-rig my kickstand with a zip tie and then I was on my way. Because I had to reconnect my kickstand spring, I decided to head over to my parents and use their garage. Thanks, Mom and Dad, for letting me use your garage. I'm cruising along, everything's going great, and then I come up to this stoplight. This is when it took the turn for the worse. As I'm approaching the stoplight, I'm checking in my mirror and I see a car behind me, but they're slowing down and then we both end up stopping. Now there's also a car in front of me, so I make sure I leave enough space between myself and the other vehicle. So I'm sitting at this light, the bike's in gear, the clutch is pulled in, and my front and rear brake are both engaged. At this point, I'm thinking everything's cool.
I was sadly mistaken.
As I was sitting there, I went to go glance at my mirror and then all of a sudden, boom! I got rear-ended. Before I go into detail on how this common practice saved my butt, let's check out the damage report.
All right, guys, I'm out in the garage. Here's the damage report. Right here, she got the Torpak really good here. This took most of the damage. I mean, it's cracked all the way up in through here, all the way up there. There's some scratches right there. And then you come back down here, she completely snapped my dog bone. No bueno. This ended up smashing into my fender, so the whole fender is just smashed in. And then she hit me hard enough to knock off the caps for my license plate, which was awesome. And then we come over here to the bags right here. Holy cow, man. She did a number. One scratch there, one scratch there. And that's all the way down to the plastic. There's no buffing that out. And then you come down over here on the rear fascia down here. That's all scratched up. I don't think you're buffing that out either. That's all the way down to the paint. So, but I'll be getting a new fender anyhow. Pretty much all the damage. I mean, at least I was okay. Nobody got hurt. I might have some whiplash. My back's starting to tighten up a little bit, but you know, it is what it is.
As you just saw, the damage was cosmetic, so thankfully I was able to ride away from the accident and make it home. Now let's dive down and see how this practice potentially saved me from further injury. First off, the bike wasn't in neutral, I was in gear with both brakes engaged. Too many times I see riders at a stoplight with their hands off the handlebars just looking around not paying attention. Now this is why it's important that your bike is in gear and you have both brakes engaged at a stoplight. If this lady would have ran into the back end of me and I was in neutral with my hands off the handlebars, I would have been launched forward and probably dropped the bike. Luckily, in this situation, I did not drop my bike. Number two is I left enough room between myself and the car in front of me. When this lady hit me, it actually pushed me forward a little bit, so my bike could have smashed into that car, causing more damage. Not to mention, if I didn't have anyone behind me and I checked my rearview mirror and I saw a car zooming back behind me, this leaves enough space for me to escape around the vehicle in front of me. Unfortunately, in this situation, I don't think I could have done anything else to prevent this. The car behind me was completely stopped. I don't know what this lady was doing. She was probably on her phone and then maybe some traffic on the side started going forward and she just mashed on the gas and just plowed right into me. I'm begging you guys, when you're at a stoplight, make sure you stay in gear, have both brakes engaged, and constantly looking in your mirror to make sure nobody's coming up behind you. It could save your life. I'm just happy that I didn't get severely injured. The bike can always be fixed and accidents happen. I'm turning this into a positive experience because now I know what I've been doing for years actually works. I don't think I could have done anything different in this situation. If you can think of anything, leave it down in the comments because I'm always open to suggestions. If you want to see another experience that I had that wasn't so great but turned it into a positive learning experience, check out this video right here. As always, this is Jogo with Jogo Motorcycle Adventures. Until next time, ride on.